pluralism its part that course is India democracy and development. So let me first contextualize this concept diversity and pluralism. Vignesh just gave a sense to the diversity and pluralism, but there is a subtle difference also. Once we will get into these two concepts, we will get a very clear picture. So what is diversity and what is pluralism? These two concepts, diversity and pluralism, mostly these two concepts are related with secularism or multiculturalism, or in a sense, democracy. And let me say also, these two concepts are indirectly related with the development. So why I say directly related with democracy, multiculturalism, secularism? These two concepts are directly related. And why I said these two concepts are indirectly related with development? To understand it, I think we need to understand the relation between the democracy and development. And there are two ways of understanding the relation between the democracy and development. One is from the binary perspective and from a dialectical perspective. From the binary perspective, democracy is just opposite to the development. So democracy means what? Democracy means it is by the people, for the people, of the people. Here basically people means those who are poor section of the society. And here development means what? Development means it is industrialization, it is elite, it is rich. So you see the binary. On one hand there are poor people, on the other hand there is rich people, right? So development stands for rich people, democracy stands for poor people, mostly. This is the binary understanding of development and democracy. Here democracy is just different to the development. So what is that dialectical? The second way is the dialectical understanding of the relation between the democracy and the development. The dialectical understanding says that without democracy, development is not possible, and without development, democracy cannot be worked out. What does it mean? I said that democracy is for poor, development is for rich, right? Then poor people they give labor, and rich people they give capital. I mean the relation, if you try to understand between the labor and capital, you will understand that without labor the capital is having no relevance, no meaning, no significance. And also without capital you cannot utilize the labor. I mean labor needs capital and capital needs labor. So from that sense you can get a sense that development needs democracy. When I'm saying development needs democracy, what does it mean? It means that for industry, for industrialization, the industrialist, they need the help of poor people, the labor. Who will give the labor? It is the poor people who will give the labor. So development needs democracy, and democracy also needs development. Without economy, without the resources, how can you maintain or how can you work with democracy, right? For democracy, if you are talking about pro people, so you have to spend for pro people. How that money will come? So it will come from the development. So in a dialectical sense, democracy is positively linked with the development, and development is also positively linked with the democracy. This is the dialectical way of understanding. And the earlier one was the binary way of understanding. The democracy and development are too extreme. They are just too opposite to each other. So between this democracy and development, you can think about secularism. You can think about multiculturalism. You can think about the concept of diversity and pluralism. As I said before, the diversity and pluralism, it is directly related with multiculturalism, with secularism, with democracy, and it is indirectly related with the development. There is no direct connection between this concept of diversity, pluralism on one hand, and development on the other. So let me start now. So I just gave a context to my talk that how diversity and pluralism is fit with this course. The name of the title is Democracy and Development. India, Democracy and Development. Let me start this session here, from here. That secularism and democracy, they are deeply related with each other. So what is important for secularism, that is also important for the democracy. What is important for secularism, that is also important for the democracy. Let's take some of the example. Let's take freedom of religion. Let's take protection of minority. So both are connected with secularism and democracy. Both are connected with secularism and democracy. So what is undemocratic, that cannot be secular, and what is non-secular, that cannot be democratic. So if you have any example of that, you can give me and I will think about it. So my position is that that what is not secular, that cannot be democratic, and what is not democratic, that cannot be secular. That's my point. Now, how can we explain the survival of secularism or democracy in India? How can we explain? There are people that they are negative about it. They say that Indian secularism is meaningless, that there is no secularism in India, there is no democracy in India. So maybe I'm not rejecting their understanding, but certainly this is a negative understanding. And I reject their negativity or cynicism. That there are different groups, there is other group that they think that they are positive about the survival or existence of secularism or democracy, right? And they explain the survival of democracy or secularism in two ways. So they explain the survival or existence of democracy or secularism in two ways. The first way is that the existence of democracy is possible due to the exposure of democratic institutional politics provided to the nationalist leadership by the Britisher in 20th century, right? So in between, I think if there is a need, I think I can also explain in Odia, right? So Bigness, can I use Odia?
Yes, sir, you can speak in Odia also. There is no problem.
Odia. Tiki Odia kahiba, because we all belong to Odisha. Our mother tongue is also Odia. And okay, I always think that language should not be the barrier of idea. Political science is all about idea, not about the language. This is my firm belief. So do it away, hella. Prathama weta kona. Semani chinta korchanti that. Existence of democracy, it is possible hai chi kahi ki na eta Britisher mane 20th century re amara nationalist leadership ko ei jo democratic institutional politics ba ame ko je democracy as a form of governance, right? Ei jinsa ta Britisher mane Indian nationalist leadership man ko eta sikhai chanti ba eta sahita ta ko introduce kari chanti. Democracy exists in India. So this is one way, and which I call, it is a procedural democracy. It is a procedural democracy. If you go to the constitution, if you go through the constitutional assembly debate, you will get this sense that our institution, our constitutions, our rules, regulation, our election, all are democratic in nature. Right. So it is one way of understanding. The second way of understanding is that the existence of democracy, it is possible in India especially I'm talking about India, in India, due to the translation of our traditional values, translation of our traditional values like pluralism, like consensus, like tolerance, like inclusion, etc., into the modern political culture. Here, it means all these concepts, whether pluralism, consensus, tolerance, inclusion, that are the part of, that has been the part of, Indian culture. That has been the part of, when I'm saying about Indian culture, I'm also saying that mostly it is a Hindu culture. So in Hinduism, you will find all this pluralism, consensus, tolerance, inclusion, you will find that. And it is because of it is part of the Indian culture, hence democracy has been successful in India in comparison to other democratic government in the world. So comparatively, Indian democracy is better than the other kinds of or other forms of democracy in the world. So one may also challenge that how you are saying that Hindu culture or Indian Indian culture you are just bringing a kind of similarity between the Indian culture and Hindu culture. Then you are saying that Hindu culture is plural in nature. Hindu culture believes in consensus. Hindu culture believes in tolerance. Hindu culture is inclusive. One may challenge me because he may have read Ambedkar's view of Hinduism, right? So those who understand Hinduism from the Ambedkar's point of view, they may just challenge me that Hindu culture. They may challenge me that Hindu culture is not plural. It doesn't believe in consensus. It is not tolerant. Then it is not inclusive, etc. Etc. But to them, I will also ask them to read that you if you will read Upanishad, if you read Kashmiri Shaiva philosophy, if you read Vaishnava theology, then you will understand a different Hinduism, a different Hindu culture. Then you may sense these values, pluralism, consensus, then tolerance, inclusion. In Hindu culture, in Hindu culture you may find. So these two way, so first way is the procedural democracy. I interpret it as procedural democracy. It has been given by Britisher to us. And second one is it is inherent in our Indian tradition or Hindu culture. And second one I call it is the substantive democracy, because it is very much part of Indian culture. That's why in India democracy is successful. Democracy in India, it is comparatively better than its counterpart in the world. So in such a context, I think we need to understand what is that pluralism, which is part of that Indian ethos, which is part of that Indian belief, Indian tradition. What is that consensus? What is that tolerance? What is that inclusion? Right? Many lectures are needed to teach and to learn how Hindu culture is tolerant, how there is a consensus within the Hindu culture, Hindu philosophy, how there is a tolerance, how Hindu culture is inclusive in nature. Many lectures are needed to understand all these points. But here I picked up this diversity and pluralism, that Hindu culture believes, inherently it believes in diversity and pluralism. And our secularism does not believe separation between the state and the church. because we have intra-caste domination, we have inter-caste domination, we have intra-religious domination, we have inter-religious domination. So when such kind of dominations are there, the state cannot be away or cannot be agnostic to all this conflict. The state has to intervene. So there, the separation between the religion and politics, it is not possible in India. So the state has to intervene. And the religion, if they are also right, they can also challenge the state. This is the link between the religion and politics in India. So our secularism, what we can say, it is an accommodative secularism, that the secular state will accommodate each and every cultural group within the India. Our secularism has to give respect to our diversity, to our plurality. It has to protect our diversity and plurality. This is the job of our secular state, to protect, to strengthen our plurality and diversity. But now, let us understand what is that plurality and what is the diversity. Mostly, these two terms, plural and diverse, they are used interchangeably. People don't understand the difference between the plural and diverse. So let me first come to what is pluralism, then we'll go to what is diversity. So what is pluralism? So pluralism means presence of many. So pluralism only speaks presence of many. It doesn't speak anything about the nature of many. So kebala mane bahut rahibe seita hocche pluralism. But tanko bhitre sei bahut ra nature ta kon thibo se bahut guda parasparo soito kemti related hebe sei bisare pluralism is silent. So how that many are structured, how they are related with one and another, pluralism or plurality is silent in it. So these many could be manifold representation of one. For example, I can give you, Hinduism is a plural religion. We have different sects within the Hinduism, Vaishnava, Saiva, all these sects are there, and all these sects, they are different from each other, but at the same time they speak one language. They are part of that Hinduism. They are part of that Hinduism, but within the Hinduism they are different. Within the Hinduism they are different, but at the end they are same. They are Hinduism. So Hinduism is a plural religion. You can get sense from it. So this, the nature of many could be manifold representation of one, or it may be separate or unequal entities. It can be separate, or it may be separate or unequal entities, and it is hierarchically arranged and are related with each other in a relationship of domination and subordination. माने अलग अलग जिनस एट दि एंड से गोटे कथा कहटा गोटे नेचर हो पारे मेनी रो गोटे नेचर कौन हो पारे ना ए अलग अलग जिनस आरंभ रु भी अलग अलग शेष रही अलग अलग आई मीन दे डोंट स्पीक वन थिंग दे आर जस्ट डिफरेंट But in the earlier example, when I said that Hinduism is a plural religion, and when I said that different sects, Vaishnava sect, Saiva sect, and so on and so forth, all these sects are inclusive with each other. They are not exclusively different. They are deeply connected. But here, they are not deeply connected. And let me give you the example of our caste system. In our caste system, a Brahmin cannot be a Dalit. A Dalit cannot be a Kshatriya. A Kshatriya cannot be a Vaishya. We are just different from the beginning. We are just different from the in the end also. So one can think about caste system as an example of many, where the where you can find different castes within the caste system. They are just separate and they are unequal entities. They are not equal. They cannot be equal. Right? Now, this is the idea of pluralism. So pluralism only says that presence of many. It doesn't speak about the nature of many. So this is the idea of pluralism that distinguishes between totalitarian and democratic polity. So if there are many, if the state is safeguarding many, if the state is promoting many, then that state is a democratic state. If the state does not respect many, if the state does not support many, then that state becomes a totalitarian state. So it is the pluralism that makes a distinction between totalitarian state and democratic state. The presence of many was seen in 20th century a minimum condition of freedom. So if when I'm saying many represents democracy and totalitarian system or state, they don't talk about many. And when there is this concept of many, then there is also the concept of freedom. So only when you have different alternative, you can choose your freedom of choose. You can choose from that alternative and you can say that, no, right now my freedom is secure. So only when you have choices, you can pick it up and you can enjoy your freedom. And this presence of many makes the freedom of choice real. If there is no many, then your freedom of choice or freedom of choose, it is unreal. You may think about in a neoliberal economy whether you do actually have freedom of choice or not. It is a matter of debate. It is a matter of debate. I'm not going into that. Now, this presence of many, it is also having two types, intergroup and intragroup. Intergroup means what? That I am different to you. This is, intra. This is intra. I am different from you. Sorry. I am different from you. That is inter. But within me, let me give you an example. Now, communism. Communism believes in democracy. Communism, the theory of communism talks about diversity, talks about democracy, talks about people, talks about people's freedom. But are they democratic within themselves? They are giving respect to the diversity. They are giving respect to the diversity, to pluralism. But do they recognize this diversity and pluralism within their ideology? So the presence of many, it should be outside the Communist Party and it should be inside the Communist Party as well. You should recognize this presence of many outside and you should recognize the presence of many inside. Then only this many, presence of many will lead to real democracy. Otherwise, you will get superficial democracy. It appears to be democratic, but it is not democratic in an exact sense. Democratizer, they have forgotten to democratize themselves. Democratizer, they have forgotten to democratize themselves. If I am not a democratic person, then I cannot give you the freedom. So, this presence of many, it must be there within the group and it must be there outside the group also. Right? Now, this presence of many is the precondition of the recognition of difference. So, pluralism, when I'm saying presence of many, I do understand it as pluralism. And when I'm saying recognition of difference, it means existence of many that are different. Existence of many that are different. Then I'm talking about the diversity. So here the distinction between the pluralism and diversity is that pluralism talks about presence of many and diversity talk about these many are different to each other. These many are exclusively different to each other. They are just different. They are not inclusive. This is the distinction between pluralism and diversity. And this diversity is heterogeneous. What do you mean by heterogeneous? That you cannot... A is different from non-A. Non-A is different from A. This is diversity. You cannot compare A with non-A. And it is incommensurable. Incommensurable means not having common factor. A and non-A, they don't have a common factor. So A and non-A, they are diverse. A and non-A, they are diverse. But pluralism speaks about presence of many. Diversity speaks about recognition of difference. So you can get the link between the pluralism and diversity. And what is that link? That link is diversity comes within pluralism, or diversity is one kind of plurality. All plurals are not diverse. Pluralism includes diversity, but diversity does not include pluralism. So pluralism ta tike broader concept. Diversity ta bhitre gote choto part. Choto part kon? Now, I'm just opposite to each other. We are not, inclusive to each other. We are just exclusive. You are different, I am different. That is diversity. Pluralism la out aspect achi. Even if we are different, there are certain common points. At the end, we are same. So, pluralism, how chi diversity plus. Pluralism is equal to diversity plus. This is the difference between the pluralism and diversity. Or to put it in another way, when we speak of diversity, we refer to multiplicity that is not collapsible into one. The many in this conception are discrete and separate entities. Diversity jatole mo kahuchi seita collapsible hei pariboni. Last seta misi pariboni. They are just different. They are discrete, they are separate entities. Each society is unique in terms of its internal structure, institution, values. Hence, it must be studied in its own term. Why should we give respect to diversity? Diversity speaks about presence of different, culture, and all these different culture, they are different to each other, and all this, each culture, it has its own right of existence. Let me give you four features of diversity. First, presence of distinct and heterogeneous culture. First characteristic of diversity, presence of distinct and heterogeneous culture. Second, each culture has an individualized particularity. That means each culture is unique. Each culture has certain different things from other cultures. Third, each culture has attributes that deserve respect. Each culture has attributes that deserve respect. That means each culture has certain uniqueness. And all these uniqueness has the right to be respected. You cannot say that this uniqueness is good, that uniqueness is bad. You cannot say that. Even the tribal religion, what we say, animism, it has something new to offer. It has certain uniqueness. It must be respected. Then fourth, each culture has something valuable to offer, and all hence all must be cherished, protected and preserved. That means there is a value orientation in the diversity. In the diversity, there is a concept of value orientation, that each culture is valuable. It has a value. It offers a value to us. Even tribal culture, it gives many democratic values to democracy. And all these, jehetu sabu values guda, pratyek culture bhitre kichhi na kichhi values achi, se culture ko amko cherish kariba pai padiba, se culture ko amko protect kariba pai padiba, se culture ko amko preserve kariba pai padiba. This is the value aspect of diversity. Now, multiculturalism endorses this idea of diversity. So, diversity means we are different, we have certain unique quality, it must be respected, it must be protected, and this multiculturalism endorses this idea of diversity rather than pluralism. Multiculturalism केवल pluralism को multiculturalism केवल pluralism को था कहूँ नहीं multiculturalism कौन कहूँ ची कि presence of many रही है out से many जो रही ले से many are diverse from each other and all these cultures are unique, they needs protection and if the state gives protection and safeguarding the rights of all the culture, from majority culture to minority culture, then we can say that India is having a multicultural state or multicultural society. Multiculturalism suggests that the distinctive particularity of each culture needs to be recognized and represented separately. Minority culture is equally important like majority culture. Minority culture is equally important to the majority culture. Poor are equally important for rich. Rich are equally important for the poor. The relation between the rich and poor is dialectical. The relation between the minority culture and majority culture, it is dialectical. They need each other. Minority needs majority and majority needs minority. This exclusive understanding is actually making our secularism as crony, as pseudo. So we have to go beyond the binary. We have to think the dialectical relation between different kind of binary. Here I am using the binary of majority and minority. Do majority and minority, they are exclusive to each other? They don't have any common point? This is the time to think about it. This is the time to protect our secularism from crony and from pseudo. The agenda of preserving marginalized culture gets justification from it. When we say talk about secularism, then important aspect of secularism is that protection of minority. Now this protection of minority culture gets justification from the multicultural arguments or from the arguments of multiculturalism. For multiculturalism, even a small culture, gude choto culture, gude bada culture, e dui jonga jakar adhikar achi semane exist kari paribe. Tume choto culture ko deny kari paribani, tume choto culture ko kahibani ki tume bada culture satre misi jao. The small culture should assimilate to the large culture or big culture. When you are doing this assimilation, then also you are going against the prescription of multiculturalism. You are denying the existence of minority culture. So the agenda of preserving minority culture gets justification from the argument of multicultural thinker or theorist. Multiculturalism speaks three important elements. Multiculturalism speaks three important elements that nuance the idea of diversity. What is the three important element? The first, it places diversity within the boundary of nation state. It places diversity within the boundary of nation state. That means we need to think about who is a minority, who is not a minority within India. Let me give you an example. Let me take Islam. Can you say that Indian Muslim is different from the world Muslim? If something will happen to Indian Muslim, then the non-Indian Muslim will not raise this issue. It doesn't happen in that way. Because Islam has a pan character. If Indian Muslim is suffering, then it hurts Muslim who are outside in India. It has a pan character. But multiculturalism says you should not see Indian Muslim as a part of pan Islam, as a part of world Muslim. Rather than you should think that Indian Muslim, they are Indian. They are within the boundary of India. So we should not connect Indian Muslim with world Muslim. Rather than we should think that what is the status of Indian Muslim today in comparison to different religious community. And accordingly, we will safeguard their rights. So this multiculturalism places diversity within the boundary of nation state. Second, while locating diversity within a society, some theorists speak of presence of heterogeneous communities within the state and some speaks of homogeneity. While locating diversity within a society, some theorists speaks of presence of heterogeneous community within the state and some speaks of homogeneity. The example I gave in the context of pluralism, that Hinduism as a plural religion, caste, you can find in caste that many is separate and unequal entities. So within this diversity, there are theorists who says that communities, they are heterogeneous communities, and communities, they are homogeneous communities. So they are both heterogeneous, they are both homogeneous. And the third important element of multiculturalism is that it distinguishes between majority and minority community. It holds that state is generally identified with majority culture, and there is an irreconcilable difference between the majority and minority culture. In such a situation, state discriminates against minority. Hence, it is concerned about minority culture and its fate within the state and polity. So multiculturalism sees state as it represents the majority culture. Multiculturalism sees there is an irreconcilable difference between the majority culture and minority culture. And since state leans towards the majority culture, there are possibilities that minority culture, the interest of minority culture, there is a possibility that it may get jeopardized. Hence, multiculturalism tries to protect this minority culture. because state is there for majority culture. Hence, multicultural, so theorists of multiculturalism, they are or they bother about the protection of minority culture. And these are the questions multicultural theorists, they are bother about. Mostly there are three questions multiculturalists are bothering about. What is that? Three questions. First, do the diverse ethnic minorities receive equal and fair treatment in public? Khali existence hai gale hobani ki minority culture, majority culture bholiya public space re tara nijara adhikar ku pai paruchita. Multiculturalism or multiculturalist are worried about it. So they, to them, equality matters. There is a equality between the majority culture and minority culture. And that equality, whether the minority culture is availing in public or not. That's the first question. Second question, do state discriminate against these communities through its policy? स्टेट जत बेले किछ गुटे पॉलिसी करूची ए पॉलिसी गुडा माइनॉरिटी कम्युनिटी को नेगेटिवली अफेक्ट करूनी त जत बेले स्टेट आणुची सिटीजनशिप अमेंडमेंट बिल जत बेले से एनआरसी इशू आणुची पार्लियामेंट रे त पास हो गला डेमोक्रेटिक मीन्स को त व्यवहार है कि ताको लॉ भी बना हो गला किंतु वर्तमान क्वेश्चन रहिला कोन कि ए जो पॉलिसी हला ए पॉलिसीटा हमरो माइनॉरिटीज मान को केमिति अफेक्ट पकौ छ हमर माइनॉरिटीज को डिस्क्रिमिनेट करू छ कि दिस इज द सेकंड क्वेश्चन मल्टीकल्चरलिस्ट दे आर वरीड अबाउट दैट एंड द थर्ड क्वेश्चन व्हाट नीड्स टू बी डन इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोवाइड इक्वल स्टेटस टू द माइनॉरिटी जते जहा कले भी माइनॉरिटी कम्युनिटी माने सर्वदा मार्जिनलाइज्ड हेइ जाउचन मेजोरिटी कल्चर को चैलेंज करी पारु नहांती पब्लिक स्पेस रे तांकर जो पोजीशन अछि ताको से माने सिक्योर करी पारु नहांती कोन ता कले माइनॉरिटी कल्चर से माने मेजोरिटी कल्चर सहित इक्वल हेबे आ इक्वल शेयर करिवे इन पब्लिक स्पेस दीज आर द थ्री क्वेश्चंस मल्टीकल्चरलिज्म इज ओरिएंटेड अबाउट Let me say, multiculturalism talks about diversity, not about pluralism. So you have to maintain the diversity. As long as diversity is there, diversity is maintained, then multiculturalism will say that I am okay. And democracy, it will be okay. Secularism, it will be okay. So maintaining diversity is very much important. And these three questions, are very much relevant for democracy to survive. So democracy, since state consciously or unconsciously relates to majority culture, then multicultural or the secular or democratic person, democratic theorists, democratic intellectual, they bother about the status of minority and they bother about these above three questions. So such questions are very much relevant for democracy to survive. Otherwise, we are likely to face an endless prospect of ethnic violence, confrontation between majority community and minority community. You look at the surrounding in India today, you will find that there are ethnic conflict, there are lynching, there are a kind of intolerance from majority culture, intolerance from the minority culture. Why it is happening? It is primarily happening that we are not realizing our secularism, we are not realizing the pluralism, tolerance, we are not realizing the inclusiveness of our Indian culture. Rather than we depend on the state, this centrist approach will not help. this centrist approach, at the end of the day, it will lead towards a continuous conflict between the majority and minority. As a result, you will find lynching, you would find ethnic violence, you will find religious communalism, etc., between the majority community and minority community. Eta ketebale stop hoba? Mu ma students manku Sambalpur re bi kahutile, eta ketebale stop hoba? Na jetebale the majority and minority community, they will think in a dialectical term, not in a binary way. They should realize ki ame parasparo exclusive nuha, ame parasparo inclusive. Minority majority ko recognize karibo, majority minority ko recognize karibo. Jate porjonto ei sense ta majority aur minority ko pakhuru no asichi, sete porjonto secularism ba multiculturalism possible nuha. Secularism, multiculturalism, state dwara jodi impose kara jaye, then it will produce counter revolution. It will not solve the problem. Rather than ei jo sense ta, ei sense ta toli jiba darkar, loko mane nije realize kariba darkar. The liberty will sacrifice for equality, and the equality must recognize the contribution of liberty. Liberty or equality bhitre jodi gote balanced relationship no asila, tebe social justice possible hobo nahi. Social justice ko possible ba social justice ko success kareba pai amku ground initiative naba pai padibo. Amku state ra policy upure kebala nirbhar kale seita chaliboni, seita amku se amku solution kebe debo nahi. So minimizing cultural discrimination, enhancing equality of culture may provide an answer to some of the most pressing concern of our time. Tanu amko cultural discrimination jonta hochi visible or invisible duita were jonta hochi taku minimize kariba pai padibo. But a sense of inequality jonta invisible were hochi taku equality aniba pai padibo. We have to enhance the equality of culture. No doubt amara legal pluralism achi, mere legal pluralism is not the sign of equality. There is a need of group equality at both social space as well as public domain. Law amko kon dekhe, we are just individual, we are equal. Constitution amko right deichi, legal pluralism achi ama pakhari, but legal pluralism will not give us equality. Equality amko dabo kie na, equality amko society dabo. State kebe amko equal mane state policy banai dabo, kintu society re to ei jinsa guda sabu operate karibo. Tenu amaro society ago conscious hoba darkar, state imposition kaam karibo nahi. So mere legal pluralism is not a sign of equality. There is a need of group equality at both social space as well as public domain for maintaining diversity. Tenu diversity ko maintain kariba pai hele amko society ra help darkar, amko society ko reform kariba pai padibo, amko society ko empower kariba pai padibo, society ko kariba pai padibo. So equality of culture, here when I'm saying equality of culture, basically I means group equality. And when I'm saying legal pluralism, I means universal citizenship. Now multiculturals or multiculturalism sees universal citizenship as deeply problematic. Multiculturalism universal citizenship ko believe kare nahi, karena universal citizenship legal pluralism ru asichi. Legal pluralism ta state ro imposed policy. Now state imposed policy re equality possible hei parunu society re. 70-75 barsha ame independence taru hei galani, ame aji kahi pare ame equal boli? Ame kahi paribani ame equal boli jodi ama constitution amku equality deichi? Karena equality state imposed re possible nuha. ତେଣୁ ମଲ୍ଟିକଲଚରାଲିଜିମ ସିଏ ୟୁନିଭର୍ସାଲ ସିଟିଜେନସିପକୁ ବିଲିଭ କରେନି, ସିଏ ଲିଗାଲ ପ୍ଲୁରାଲିଜିମକୁ ବିଲିଭ କରେନି। ୟୁନିଭର୍ସାଲ ସିଟିଜେନସିପ ସିଜ୍ ଅଲ୍ ସିଟିଜେନ୍ସ ଏଜ୍ ଇକ୍ୱାଲ ଇରେସ୍ପେକ୍ଟିଭ ଅଫ୍ ଦେୟାର ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ଫର୍ମସ ଅଫ୍ ଡାଇଭର୍ସିଟି। ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଥ୍ରୁ ଇଟ୍ସ ପଲିସି ମେ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେଟ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ ଅର୍ ନନ୍ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେଟ୍ ହିମ୍। ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଯେଉଁ ଗୋଟେ ପଲିସି କରୁଛି, ଆଇଦର ଗୋଟେ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ ତା ଦ୍ୱାରା ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେଟ୍ ହେବ ବା ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେଟ୍ ହେବନି। ଇଫ୍ ଦ ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେଟ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ ଦେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏକ୍ସକ୍ଲୁଡିଂ। ଇଫ୍ ଦ ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଇଜ୍ ନନ୍ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେଟିଂ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ, ଆଇଦର ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେଟ୍ କରୁଛି ବା ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେଟ୍ କରୁନି। ଯେତେବେଳେ ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେଟ୍ କରୁଛି ଦେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏକ୍ସକ୍ଲୁଜନ୍। ଯେତେବେଳେ ଷ୍ଟେଟ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେସନ୍ କରୁନାହିଁ ଦେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଆସିମିଲେସନ୍। ଆଣ୍ଡ ବୋଥ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଏକ୍ସକ୍ଲୁଜନ୍ ଆସିମିଲେସନ୍ ଆର୍ ଦି ସିମ୍ବଲ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଇନ୍ଟଲରେନ୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏନଫ୍ କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ ଫର୍ ଦି ଡିସ୍ଏଷ୍ଟାବ୍ଲିଶମେଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ମଲ୍ଟିକଲଚରାଲ ସୋସାଇଟି। ତେଣୁ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ ଲେବୁଲରେ ଯେଉଁ ଆସିମିଲେସନ୍ ହେଲା ବା ଯେଉଁ ଏକ୍ସକ୍ଲୁଜନ୍ ହେଲା ଷ୍ଟେଟର ପଲିସି ମାଧ୍ୟମରେ, ଏ ଦୁଇଟା ଯାକ କଲଚୁରାଲ କଣ୍ଟେକ୍ସଟରେ ଇନ୍ଟଲରେଣ୍ଟ। କଲଚୁରାଲ କଣ୍ଟେକ୍ସଟରେ ୱି ଆର୍ ଡିସ୍ରେସ୍ପେକ୍ଟିଂ ଟୁ ଦି ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟେନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ମାଇନୋରିଟି କଲଚର। ତେଣୁ ମାଇନୋରିଟି କଲଚରକୁ ଏସିମିଲେଟ୍ କରିବା ଉଚିତ ନୁହଁ କି ମାଇନୋରିଟି କଲଚରକୁ ଏକ୍ସକ୍ଲୁଡ଼ କରିବା ଉଚିତ ନୁହଁ, ଟ୍ରାଇବାଲ ମାନଙ୍କୁ ମେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ୍ରିମ୍କୁ ଆଣିବା ଉଚିତ ନୁହଁ। ଆମେ ଯଦି ମେନ୍ଷ୍ଟ୍ରିମ୍କୁ ଟ୍ରାଇବାଲ ମାନଙ୍କୁ ଆଣୁଛେ ତେବେ ଆମେ ଟ୍ରାଇବାଲ କଲଚରର ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ଉପରେ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ପୁଟ୍ କରୁଛୁ। ଟ୍ରାଇବାଲ କଲଚର ଆଉ ରହିବନି, ସେଇଟା ଆମେ ଏସିମିଲେସନ୍ କରୁଛୁ। ଆଉ ଯଦି ଆମେ ଟ୍ରାଇବାଲ କଲଚରକୁ ଇଗ୍ନୋର କରୁଛେ ବା ଟ୍ରାଇବାଲ କଲଚରକୁ ଆମେ ଡିସ୍କ୍ରିମିନେଟ୍ କରୁଛେ ଦେନ୍ ୱି ଆର୍ ଏକ୍ସକ୍ଲୁଡିଂ ଦି ଟ୍ରାଇବାଲ କଲଚର ୱାଇଲ୍ ଥିଙ୍କିଂ ଅର୍ ମେକିଂ ଏ ପଲିସି। ଆଣ୍ଡ ବୋଥ୍ ଆସିମିଲେସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏକ୍ସକ୍ଲୁଜନ୍, ଏ ଦୁଇଟା ଯାକ ଟ୍ରାଇବାଲ କଲଚରର ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ପାଇଁ ଇଣ୍ଟଲରେଣ୍ଟ। ଏ ଦୁଇଟା ଯାକ ଜିନିଷ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏନଫ୍ କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ ଫର୍ ଦି ଡିସ୍ଏଷ୍ଟାବ୍ଲିଶମେଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଏ ମଲ୍ଟିକଲଚରାଲ ସୋସାଇଟି। ମଲ୍ଟିକଲଚରାଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ଚାହୁଁଛି ଯିଏ ଯେଉଁ କଲଚରରେ ଅଛି ସେଇ କଲଚରରେ ସେ ରହୁ, ତାର ଯେଉଁ ଡାଇଭର୍ସିଟି ଅଛି ସେ ଡାଇଭର୍ସିଟିକୁ ପ୍ରୋଟେକ୍ଟ କରାଯାଉ, ତାକୁ ଏସିମିଲେଟ୍ ନ କରାଯାଉ, ତାକୁ ଏକ୍ସକ୍ଲୁଡ଼ ନ କରାଯାଉ। ସେଥିପାଇଁ କେବଳ ଲିଗାଲ ପ୍ଲୁରାଲିଜିମଟା ଏନଫ୍ ନୁହଁ, ସେଥିପାଇଁ କେବଳ ୟୁନିଭର୍ସାଲ ସିଟିଜେନସିପଟା ଏନଫ୍ ନୁହଁ। ଦେନ୍ ଏଠି ମଲ୍ଟିକଲଚରାଲିଜିମ ତାହେଲେ କହୁଛି କ'ଣ? ଯଦି ଲିଗାଲ ପ୍ଲୁରାଲିଜିମ ମଲ୍ଟିକଲଚରାଲିଜିମ କହୁଛି ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଏନଫ୍ କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ ଫର୍ ପ୍ରୋଟେକ୍ଟିଂ ଦି ଡାଇଭର୍ସିଟି ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏଷ୍ଟାବ୍ଲିଶିଂ ଏ ମଲ୍ଟିକଲଚରାଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ଆଣ୍ଡ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରେଙ୍ଗଦେନିଂ ଦି ସେକୁଲାରିଜିମ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରେଙ୍ଗଦେନିଂ ଦି ଡେମୋକ୍ରାସି, ତାହେଲେ କରିବା କ'ଣ? ନା ଟୁ ଏଷ୍ଟାବ୍ଲିଶ ଏ ମଲ୍ଟିକଲଚରାଲ ସୋସାଇଟି ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ନିଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏଷ୍ଟାବ୍ଲିଶିଂ ଗ୍ରୁପ୍ ଇକ୍ୱାଲିଟି ଅର୍ ଗ୍ରୁପ୍ ଡିଫରେନ୍ସିଏଟେଡ୍ ରାଇଟ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍, ନଟ୍ ଏଫର୍ମେଟିଭ ଆକ୍ସନ୍। ତେଣୁ ଆମକୁ ୱି ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ଗୋ ବିୟଣ୍ଡ ଦିସ୍ ୟୁନିଭର୍ସାଲ ସିଟିଜେନସିପ୍, ୱି ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ଗୋ ବିୟଣ୍ଡ ଟୁଡେଜ୍ ଏଫର୍ମେଟିଭ ଆକ୍ସନ୍, ୱି ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ଗୋ ବିୟଣ୍ଡ ପ୍ରିଭେଲିଂ ସୋସିଆଲ ଜଷ୍ଟିସ୍ ଟୁଡେ। କେଉଁଠିକି ଯିବା? ନା ୱି ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ଥିଙ୍କ ଏବାଉଟ୍ ଗ୍ରୁପ୍ ଡିଫରେନ୍ସିଏଟେଡ୍ ରାଇଟ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍। ମୁଁ ଏଇଠି ଷ୍ଟପ୍ କରୁଛି, ଆଇ ଏମ୍ ଷ୍ଟପିଂ ଇଟ୍ ହିଅର୍ because once I enter to the group differentiated right system, minimum it will take 1 hour. And to understand this group differentiated right system, I will ask you to read a book, Multicultural Path by Gurpreet Mahajan. Multicultural Path by Gurpreet Mahajan. In the fourth chapter, she has talked about citizenship and group differentiated rights. I urge you to read, I urge you to understand, I urge you to be very critical, and then you ask me about your confusion. then we will try to sort it out. So thank you. Thank you very much.
Good morning, sir. Hello.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning, sir. Sir, yes. my name is Indra Tripathi. And hello.
Yes, sir.
Sir, good morning, sir. My name is Indra Tripathi, sir. Sir, I have a question. Sir, is protective discrimination, is it good for both the minority section people and for the majority section people in a society in a practical way? I'm asking this question in a practical way. Is it good for both the minority section people and both for the majority section people in a practical way? Is it good for the society?
Okay, I will answer it, no problem. Let me take some other questions.
Yes, sir. Sir, I have more questions.
Oh, thank you, sir. Yes.
Yes, Vignesh.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. You explained elaborately what is diversity and pluralism, what is tolerance. You narrate all the things in a specific manner. Right now, sir, I'm reading the questions. What are the questions from the different students? So I read one by one. Okay, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, of course.
Sir, first question is, okay, sir. Sir, first question is, what is the difference between a diversity and a pluralism?
Yes. First, second.
Second is, sir, pluralism is talking about coexistence of different cultures, and diversity represent the notion of differentiation. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir, third question is, why human rights are important?
Okay. More second question to bujhi parleni. Author, repeat for the second question.
Pluralism is talking about coexistence of different cultures and diversity. And diversity represents the notion of differentiation.
Our question kaana? What is the question?
Sir,
this is a statement.
Different? Sir,
what is the
difference?
Question actually, Vignesh? Difference between the diversity and pluralism.
Yes, sir.
Only this question, diversity and pluralism, what is the difference?
No, sir. Many more questions, sir. I just repeat one by one.
Question,
sir.
Sir, I have one more question. This is my last question. Sir, as we know, India is the largest democratic country. India is a very unique form of democracy. Sir, my question is, as we know, in India, there is a multi-party system. So my question is that, sir, is social pluralism is the only reason behind the adoption of multi-party system in India? Is it the only reason? Because in India there is a multi-party system, sir. Many writers have written that the main reason behind the adoption of multi-party system in our country is the social pluralism. Sir, is it the only reason behind the adoption of multi-party system in India? Thank you so much.
Okay. Hello.
Yes.
Hello. Sir, a question from business. Professor Sonnavai Madam. Am I audible, sir?
Ha.
Yes. Sir, a question, madam. What is the exact difference between the two concepts, pluralism and diversity? Is it not a fact that a society of diverse elements demanded for the setting up a plural society?
Again, the last sentence.
Sir, Is it not a fact that a society of diverse elements demanded for the setting of a plural society?
Acha.
Sir, my next question. What is internal migration? Okay, sir. Next question, sir. How democracy will protect it?
What?
From, sir?
What democracy will protect it?
Sir, I repeat the question, sir. A question from Tarun from Public Administration Department. It's not democracy is an utopian concept. Right, sir? Why it's a role of majority in practical, where it's a role of majority in practical and game of numbers and game of numbers at the end of the day. How democracy will protect it? How democracy will protect it from crony capitalism, from so-called public policy making? Next question, sir. What are the ethnic challenges to the nation state? And one question from Samir Kumbhar. Sir, how tribal culture dismantling? Dismantling the values of mainstream society?
Yes,
sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Only this much?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. You know, we need to be very serious while asking question and while answering also. Right? So sometimes, you know, when you are asking question, you may not speak what you understand, and I may not understand what you ask, right? So there is always a communication gap. For that, I think we need to put our certain, you know, some seriousness, so that we can deal with the question and answer it in a very authentic sense, right? So the first question, what that protective discrimination in the practical sense, right? This is, I will say that we need to understand the relation between the theory and practice. Our theories are not bad, but our practice do not follow the theory. This protective discrimination as a theory, it has its own relevance. I will not go into it. It has its own relevance. Theory is very good, perfect, no problem. But when that protective discrimination is applied in practice, those who are getting benefits of this protective discrimination, they are not realizing the theoretical relevance of that protective discrimination. So in a practical sense, it is unfortunate that our practice of protective discrimination is not corresponding to the theoretical necessity of protective discrimination. And perhaps it is because of this reason the entire social justice movement has failed till now. Those who are part of that social justice movement, they cannot explain the emergence of Modi in 2014. If their protective discrimination was all right, if it was pro-poor, if it was democratic, if it was socialist, if it was secular, but suddenly how Modi emerged? That means there are certain problems in this protective discrimination. And when I'm saying in a practical sense, there are certain problems in protective discrimination, it also indicates that there is certain flaws in the theory. Aw sei flaw guda kemiti janibo na jete bele self introspection hobo tume jete porjonto nijuko kohutubo mu thik achi tume tumo bhul jani paribuni tamku chinta kariba pai padibo ki mu jonta prescribe karuchi seita jete bele jane practice karuchi aw sie taro mu jonta chinta kariki taku prescribe kartili sie practice jete bele karuchi mor jo chinta dhara ko से प्लेस करई पारुनी ता माने कोठी ना कोठी मो चिंता रे किछि त्रुटि रही छी आ किछि जिंस मते प्रोटेक्टिव डिस्क्रिमिनेशन ल ऐड करिवार अछि बा किछि जिंस प्रोटेक्टिव डिस्क्रिमिनेशन ल सबस्ट्रैक्ट करिवार अछि तनो देयर आर सर्टेन थ्योरेटिकल फ्लो जत बले कोनोसी भी जिंस प्रैक्टिस रे थ्योरी फॉलो हे पारु नाही जत बले प्रैक्टिस थ्योरी को फॉलो करि पारु नाही सत बले जानि नबो देयर आर सर्टेन फ्लोज इन द थ्योरी. But what are that flaws? Do I have that ready-made answer? No, I don't have any ready-made answer. I can say certain flaws. You can also challenge me. So it is by, you know, trial and error. It is by dialogue. It is by discussion. Then only, or it is by dialectics. One can understand what are the theoretical flaws in the protective discrimination. Why protective discrimination in a practical sense it has failed? Why social justice has become the victim of its own success? We need to think about that. The second question is that social pluralism and multi-party system. See, India is a very complex situation. I cannot deny that our party system does not evolve from our identities. So identities, on the basis of identities, you may find certain political party, regional parties. You can think about the examples. But there are also party, let me say party, left party, let me say Congress party. Are they based on certain kind of identity, or they are based on certain kind of ideology, certain kind of philosophy? So this multi-party system does not necessarily always based on our ethnic identity. And I do understand when you are saying social pluralism, I do understand various cleavages. And I do understand these cleavages at different kinds of identity. So my humble submission is that not all political party are based on cleavages. Not all political parties are based on ethnic identity. Then diversity and pluralism, the difference. Mo talk re bhi kahichi, au thare bhi repeat karuchi. कि प्लुरालिज्म कहुचे प्रेजेंस ऑफ मेनी बट से सेटा कहुनी से मेनी केमिति परस्पर सहित रिलेटेड हेबे से मेनी भितरे कौन रिलेशन रहिबो से मेनी भितरे हायरार्की रो के ऊपर रहिबो के तळे रहिबो से विषय रे से किछि कथा कहुनी प्लुरालिज्म कहुनी डिफरेंस कथा. So pluralism does not speak about difference. Diversity that speaks about difference. So I am saying pluralism is equal to diversity plus. That means pluralism speaks about many interrelated with each other, that many may be different to each other exclusively. That is pluralism. Diversity mane kona? Now, if that many is interrelated with each other, then it is not diversity. That elite, that many must be different from each other. That many will not interrelated. That many is mutually exclusive to each other. That is diversity. And a diversity aori chatta feature kona mu jonda kahitili na diversity ra feature hochi heterogeneity. It is incommensurable. Then every entity of the diversity has certain particularity, uniqueness. Every entity of diversity must be respected. Every entity of diversity has a valuable or a value to offer. That value needs to be cherished, protected, and preserved. So this is the difference between the pluralism and diversity. Jodi ba interchangeably loko byabahar karuchanti, pluralism re kon hauchi na pluralism talks about both interconnectedness and diverse, and diversity talks about difference. So diversity is one kind of plural, or diversity is plural. All plurals are not diverse, but all diverse are plural. So diversity is part of pluralism. Diversity is part of pluralism. But pluralism is not part, I mean pluralism, eta ko ame emiti kahi pariya gote boro goal bhitre gote choto goal ta achi. Se boro goal ta hocchi pluralism, se choto goal ta hocchi diversity. So diversity is one kind of pluralism. Diversity is one kind of pluralism. तापर गोटे क्वेश्चन थिला कौन ना इंटरनल माइग्रेशन बट बिगनेश मत क्वेश्चन बाबद आउटिके किसी एक्सप्लेन कर कि इंटरनल माइग्रेशन सहित ए जो आम प्लुरालिज्म आउ डाइवर्सिटी कथा कहचु हाउ इट इज लिंक्ड मैंने हाउ कैन आई और हाउ आई अंडरस्टैंड दिस क्वेश्चन इंटरनल माइग्रेशन इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ प्लुरालिज्म एंड डाइवर्सिटी प्लीज एनलाइटन मी फास्ट मु आगे क्वेश्चन ता बुझिने देन आई विल आंसर
सर इट्स अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम अ स्कॉलर
नहीं इट्स ओके नॉट अ बट आई डोंट आई वांट टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट क्वेश्चन लेट दैट स्कॉलर आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन आई नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट
यस
नहीं कई स्कॉलर नहांती ठीक अच्छे देन डेमोक्रेसी एज एन यूटोपिया द रोल ऑफ सेटा से क्वेश्चन आउट के रिपीट करला डेमोक्रेसी एज यूटोपिया से क्वेश्चन था हां
सर रिपीट वंस अगेन यस सर
हां
इज इट नॉट डेमोक्रेसी इज एन यूटोपियन कांसेप्ट
यस
व्हेयर इट्स ए रोल ऑफ मेजॉरिटी
ओके आई गॉट इट See, this is the problem. I mean, majoritarianism is always a problem of democracy. Now, democracy, in order to be democratic, you have to dismantle this number game. You have to dismantle this majoritarianism. How to dismantle? Now, there is concept of deliberative democracy. The democracy will based on deliberation. What is deliberation? You need to understand. There are many, you know, principles of deliberation. When I am deliberating with you, I should not violate any principle. Musa principle gura ebe kahuni ethi kahuni. Privately, you can ask me, giving me email or calling in my number, or after reading certain text on deliberative democracy. We can also discuss. But the end result of deliberative democracy is that I may not agree with you, but I will not disagree with you. Mu tuma soita ekamata nuha, kintu tame jodi e decision ta nabo, mu tumaku birodh bi karibini. Tabe kouthi na kouthi mu tuma soita agree karuchi. Tenu jo minority, karna majority adhare decision niya jauchi, kintu seti minority mankara objection rahiboni. Majority mankara kama hochi minority mankara consensus ku draw kariba. Minority mankara consent ku draw kariba. Minority may not agree with majority, but minority will not disagree with majority. So from that sense, from deliberation, from deliberative democracy, I don't think democracy is utopia. It is we who can make democracy. It is we who are defeating democracy. So it depends the quality of our representative. Kete quality politician mane parliament ko dauchanti. Jadi quality loko jibe, tabe nischit hobe. Constituent assembly jo ame kahue, it's a legal paradise. Kouna me constituent assembly amar jetale tiyari hala, you know, under the Dr. Baba Sahib Ambedkar, that assembly was a legal paradise. All the members are intellectual. They are expert in legal matter. So only when you are having a heavy brain, a talented brain, not like contemporary politician, when they are more than the politician, they are statesmen, then only they can understand the meaning and significance of deliberation. And once you are following the deliberation, then my dear student or friend, democracy is not utopia. Aku achieve kori hobo kebol amku right loko ko parliament ko pathaibar achi, kebol right loko election ladibar achi, kebol amku 500 taka nei ki vote dabar nahi, we will not accept money. So we have to be very honest, truthful. Jona Gandhi kahithile Gandhi ka value, we have to hold that Gandhian value. Then only democracy can be protected from a utopian idea. So I reject those who are saying democracy is utopia. I reject it 100%. Then ethnic challenges to the nation state. How do you repeat, Kalo Sita?
Yes, sir. What are the ethnic challenges to the nation state?
Ethnic challenges to the nation state. I mean, who asked this question? Like a student or scholar?
Students. Pragyandas.
Student. We have multiple identities. We have caste identity, we have gender identity, we have class identity, we have regional identity, we have also identity like we are intelligent, I am intelligent, you are dull. That is also one kind of identity. If we will understand our identity perfectly, if we will not allow the class of identity, if we understand the negative side of our identity, then ethnic conflict will not happen. Why ethnic conflicts are happening? It is because we are misunderstanding our identity, we are applying our identity in a negative sense, we are becoming opportunistic, we want profit. This is the prime cause the nation state is facing right now. You should know that I have the right to swing my hand until and unless it touches your nose. So my identity should not dismantle your identity. If I want profit, the other is also wanting it. Hence, the major ethnic challenge to our nation state is that we are trapped by our identity, and our identity has become our selfish interest. And to go out of it, we need dialectical understanding. And to be dialectics, you have to read, you have to ask a question, and you have to continue a dialogue with each other without any fear. So this is the major ethnic challenges to the nation state system. Both majority and minority, they are thinking secularism as a common. बलिदान दरकार आज मुख्यमंत्री जमती कहरी जे मो पांठी को टंका दियो जी एक्चुअली आम को टंका दौंस दरमार से आम पाखर भी टंका डिमांड कर बुझार अच्छी जन पाखर ने हमनी जन को दबापी भी पड़ो यू हाव टू सैक्रिफाइस some of your earning, you have to sacrifice your identity for the sake of other identity. Jonta ye kahutle misu mara deha edesa mati re desa basi chali jaan tuma pithi re, ta mane kon, ta mane mu mara identity ku sacrifice karuchi. So the major challenges to our nation state system is that ebe slogan ta change hoi jaichi, seta kon change hoichi na misu samastanka deha edesa mati re मु चली जाए तांकरी पिठी रे सेटा होचु मेजर चैलेंज एथनिक चैलेंज टू आवर नेशन सिस्टम एंड द लास्ट क्वेश्चन इज दैट जोंटा समीर पचारची द हाउ ट्राइबल कल्चर इज डिसमेंटलिंग द वैल्यूज ऑफ मेनस्ट्रीम कल्चर समीर एक्चुअली उल्टा कहूची मु तार उल्टाटा कहूची मु कहूची कि मेनस्ट्रीम कल्चर ट्राइबल कल्चर को डिसमेंटल करुची ना मेनस्ट्रीम कल्चर इज ट्राइंग टू एसिमिलेट ट्राइबल कल्चर इनटू इट्स ओन फोल्ड आ जत बेले ट्राइबल कल्चर टा एसिमिलेट हो तबे ट्राइबल कल्चर तो रही एंड दिस विल बी द रीजन ऑफ द डिसएस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ ए मल्टीकल्चरल सोसाइटी सो आई एम जस्ट सेइंग द ऑपोजिट इट इज द मेनस्ट्रीम कल्चर व्हिच इज ट्राइंग टू डिसमेंटल द ट्राइबल कल्चर Let the tribal culture be there in Kandhamal. Let Christian missionary and Vishwa Hindu Parishad stop their conversion, anti-conversion, or reconversion there. Both are problematic so far as multiculturalism is concerned. But it is unfortunate our secular intellectuals, mostly they are multicultural intellectual. I am interchangeably using it secular intellectual and multicultural intellectual. They are silent about the conversion by Christian missionary, but they are vocal about the reconversion by Vishwa Hindu Parishad. This is the major challenge of ethnic challenge of nation state system, that you are speaking half truth. You have to speak the truth. You should not be silent. You should go above than your identity. Then only democracy is possible, then only secularism is possible, then only multiculturalism is possible, then only the fruits of development can be reached, fruits of development can be reached to the last person in the queue. So thank you, Vignesh.
Sir, one question. Sir, one more question.
Okay.
Sir, how democracy will protect it from crony capitalism? From the so-called public policy making.
How democracy will
protect it? Yes, sir. Protect it from crony capitalism.
Actually, it is a very difficult question. I cannot answer. How democracy will protect from the crony capitalism? It means we are all trapped by the neoliberal economy, where the Prime Minister Modi is with the Tata Birla. And Ambani, And when Narendra Modi is Tata Birla Ambani, then what impression the last person in the queue is getting on Narendra Modi? I think it's a very difficult question. I think I should not give a superficial answer.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you okay. so much, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Hello. Lastly, I would like to invite Dr. Arun Patnaik, sir. He will say something about the sessions.
thank you. Himanshu.
Yes, sir.
Acha, subha sunuchu ta. Sunuchu.
Yes, sir.
Haan, suna jauchi, sir. Suna jauchi.
See, tame Gurpreet Mahajan boy out here seriously padidala. Seriously padiya pala tam bahut mistake kala kana Gurpreet Mahajan boy re bahut error achi. Conceptual error, as for example, to sonna pangar question ra jodi thike bujhtan to you would have got a critical point about Gurpreet Mahajan. For example, in my view, diversity is an empirical field. It's not a conceptual field. The varieties of diversities. In empirical life of human societies or nation states, you have varieties of diversities. Question is, how do you recognize them? Now, so far as pluralism is concerned, is a doctrine, it is a theory. So also multiculturalism is another theory. And the difference is, both of them are trying to talk about diversities. So Sonnappa is right, saying that diversity is the definite starting point for understanding pluralism. In a way, you are saying that, but you are not admitting it. In a way, you reveal that pluralism is also a doctrine of many. That means you are talking about diversity. So diversity is empirical. That is not a theoretical concept. It is an empirical field. The question is, how do you recognize this empirical field? For example, the liberal doctrine of diversity is known as pluralism. Whereas the communitarian doctrine of diversity is known as multiculturalism. That is the difference. Both of them talk about diversity. Liberals mm-hmm. talk about one diversity, that is known as pluralism. Whereas multiculturalism is about another kind of diversity. They also talk about same empirical reality. They discover this kind of, but that is also about another doctrine of diversity. Difference in the, therefore the question is, the question of difference between pluralism and multiculturalism, not between difference between pluralism and diversity or multicultural and diversity. So both talk about diversity. Diversity can't be contrasted with pluralism. Diversity can't be contrasted with multiculturalism. But pluralism can be contrasted with multiculturalism. That is the liberal and communitarian doctrines can be contrasted with each other. Both talk about diversity. What is the difference? Pluralism talks about a cultural notion of individual. Individual diversity and collective diversities. Civil society is about diversity. Association life is diversity, but association life and individual liberty, they are different kinds of diversities. Now, in the liberal doctrine, liberal theory, discuss individual is social neutral. Individual, once you have civil society, individual is a governor of life, and individuals come together, form varieties of associations, and those associations need mediation by state. Therefore, individuals need associations in church, in education, in family, in trade unions, in pressure groups, varieties of organizations need. So they need complex mediation by state. Therefore, in the liberal doctrine, individual is primary. The primary unit is individual. And individual generated societies or associations is to be understood to conceptualize. It's their freedom, their free space that is to safeguarded by liberal society and liberal state. Therefore, liberal doctrine is essentially about individual freedom and individuals' need for associations and their freedom, which is to be safeguarded by the state. Whereas the communitarian doctrine doesn't give up, but communitarian doctrine is slightly divergent. Communitarian doctrine tries to say that individual is social animal. It's socially embedded. You cannot understand individual by extrapolating individual from the social context. You cannot simply, therefore, there is no abstract society. There is no abstract individual. A concrete individual is connected with multiple diverse elements, including kind of thing civil society talks about it. Therefore, the communitarians basically argue that community is the primary unit, not individual. But now that that thesis has been contested by many people. Now there are liberal communitarians like Charles Taylor. They argue that even though communitarian, community is primary unit, but within the community, there is also individual autonomy, individual difference that must be respected. Therefore, there are slight differences in the communitarian thinking. They accommodate the idea of liberal pluralism to some extent. But the basic difference between communitarian and plural thinking is individual is a unit for plural thinking, for liberal thinking, and community is a unit for communitarian thinking. There are different nuances, there are variations. That is about both talk about diversity. You don't contrast diversity with communitarian or pluralism. Just, contrast is misleading. Gurpreet Mahajan has done a misleading picture. You took her book seriously. Huh? Don't read everything seriously. You are saying we should be serious. So don't take all books seriously. therefore, the time has come for us to criticize all these people. Indian thinkers have misled the entire world, I tell you. It's a complete misunderstanding of everything. Secularism is thoroughly misunderstood. And even this communitarian approach is thoroughly misunderstood. Even liberal pluralism thoroughly misunderstood. I don't know what kind of society we have built. We're living in the world of misunderstanding, more or less in India. But in the course of misunderstanding, you find partial understanding. Because what a beauty of Indian life is, at least we partially understand. For example, Indian plural thinkers partially understand individual freedom. Individual freedom is primary. Constitution talks about individual freedom. But if you look at the Constitution, it is a balanced document. It balances group rights, community rights, with individual rights. Therefore, Constitution is a document that talks about diversity in a plural sense, in a communitarian sense, in an individual sense, in a group sense. Constitution is right place where you see in the science, right kind of synthesis between liberal doctrine of individual rights and collective bodies required to facilitate those rights, and community-oriented rights, group-oriented rights, and how state and communities must safeguard those rights. The Constitution of India is a classic example of a synthesis between plural doctrine and communitarian doctrine. This point we missed. It is important for students to know that they read the Constitution carefully. They will find that the two doctrines work in tandem. There may be some contradiction, but they work in tandem. And the Constitution is a classic document of great synthesis. We, the leftists, both communitarian intellectuals in India and the liberal intellectuals, misled ourselves by not reading the Constitution properly. Read the document properly, you will understand that how both the doctrines are useful to understand diversities in India. Secondly, make a small point and end here. Indian context, multiculturalism, see, there is another problem. Multiculturalism in the Western sense means communities are independent of each other. You are dealing with communities which are independent of each other, therefore their rights must be safeguarded. Because they are independent, therefore the autonomy must be safeguarded. So ontology of independence must be safeguarded by a theory. So the public policy, theory making, law making is to safeguard autonomy. Autonomy is intrinsic and therefore that must be safeguarded by policy making. But Indian history, we don't have such communities. We don't have independent communities in India. Recall Gandhi. Gandhi's idea is communities in India live in oceanic form. India is a history of oceanic communities. Oceanic communities means each particle of ocean mingles with, interconnected with many other particles, and therefore the ocean is formed. Therefore, the communities, JP says, each village, each individual in the village is connected with village community. And village community has many communities. Occupational communities are many. And then there is a territorial community. Each individual connected with occupational community, each individual connected with territorial community, and each village occupational community, each village territorial community, connect with primary communities, secondary communities, provincial communities, state level communities, and national level communities, and global community. The entire globe is our life. The Vasudeva Kutumbakam is a philosophy of Indians. Indians have never given up this idea. that world is our own, and therefore in my village I belong to the whole world. Therefore, this is an idea which is there with most of us. Commonsensically, everybody talk to any ordinary people, they will say, "Oh, my village. I'm Indian. I'm Bharat. Bharat begins from my village." Virat peasants told Nehru, "Bharat begins from my village. On this side of Ganga." They told to Nehru was soft. Now this point, it's important for us to understand that Indian communities are not autonomy seeking. They are not independent minded. They only require protection of rights. But nevertheless, they are connected with other communities. Therefore, this lady, CSDS, there is one lady, I forgot her name, Dayakrishna's daughter. She says that India, you don't have multicultural communities.
Kavita Krishna.
Another lady, I forget. Dayakrishna's daughter. Philosopher Dayakrishna, Rajasthan. So she says, India, you don't have multicultural society. Indian society, intercultural society. Communities interpenetrate to each other. They are like convergent circles. They are already doing hand-holding. One circle mixes with other circle. One circle shares ideas, food habits, customs, and cultural habits, language of another community, neighboring community. Therefore, neighbors, they borrow from each other's activities. They borrow from each other's requirements. They borrow from each other's format, designs, plans. They share. They're different. I'm not saying they're same, but they're different, but they share each other so well. Therefore, ocean is formed in the bedrock of each village. Gandhi says, each village is a microcosm of ocean, the oceanic community. Therefore, Gandhi would have said, Indian society is intercultural society, is oceanic society. It's not society of autonomous republics, autonomous communities. Here, communities co-mingle, they cohabit, they learn from each other, they adopt from each other, they borrow from each other's culture, they celebrate each other's culture. Onam is celebrated by Muslims. Pongal is celebrated by Muslims of South India. And Muslim Ramzan is celebrated by Hindus. Hindus go in begging for Ramzan alms. Do you know that? They go for begging along with Muslims while they beg from house to house for Ramzan devotees. So this is our culture. This culture should not be ignored by theory. Theory must respect our own tradition, our own diversity, where communities co-mingle, they converse, they borrow from each other, they adopt each other's cultural habits. So therefore, I would end here. Diversity is therefore an empirical concept. And pluralism is a liberal doctrine of diversity, and communitarianism is a communitarian doctrine of diversity. So, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Last questions. Himanshu, sir.
Bigness, more just Patnaik Sangha context about the coach. Sir, Apono. इंडियन कंटेक्स्ट रे जो प्लुरालिज्म आउ डाइवर्सिटी को बुझुचंती आउ ताको कहउचंती कि दैट इन इंडियन कंटेक्स्ट द अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ प्लुरालिज्म एंड डाइवर्सिटी इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम यूरोप राइट तो मु स्टूडेंट मान को पर्सपेक्टिव रु कहउची माने मु जदी गुटे स्टूडेंट हेबी मु चाहिबी कि मते अपन इमते गुटे बहीटे बा गुटे आर्टिकल ते रेफर करंतु जोंठी हमरो इंडियन डाइवर्सिटी आउ प्लुरालिज्म को डील करा जाय छी एंड पुनी डिस्टिंक्ट माने सेपरेट करा जाय छी माने यूरोपियन थारु कि यूरोप रे प्लुरालिज्म डाइवर्सिटी अलका इंडिया रा अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ प्लुरालिज्म एंड डाइवर्सिटी अलका नो डाउट मु गुरप्रीत महाजन बहीटा को ही पढ़ीतिले आ मु सेटा पिलां को भी कहि छी लास्ट रे सेइके सब जिंस मेंशन अछि बट एकेडमिक्स इज ऑल अबाउट मु आउट अगर स्टूडेंट मान को भी कहू छी पटनायक सर मोर टीचर हिज माय मेंटर तो टीचर मानकर काम स्टूडेंट मानकर फ्लोज को धरिबा आ एकेडमिक्स रो काम होउची आमे परस्पर रो फ्लोज को सब धरिबा ता माने आमे भूल करूछु आमो भूल को जानिबाटा होउची एकेडमिक्स भूल को जानिबाटा होउची एकेडमिक्स तनो सर सही कॉन्टेक्स्ट रे मते किछि जिंस एनलाइटन करचंती एंड थैंकफुल एंड मु सर को पाकर चाहूची कि गुरप्रीत महाजन को इमती को आपण को पाखरे मटेरियल्स अछि जोंटा पढ़ी के मु गुरप्रीत महाजन लो जो एंटायर थियोराइजेशन करी छि जे से प्लुरलिज्म आ डाइवर्सिटी भितरे जो गुटे डिस्टिंक्शन आनी छि से बहीटा सेइटा को चैलेंज करा दे
सेमति
कोनोसी अछि कि मटेरियल
जयप्रकाश नारायणंकर द आईडिया ऑफ इंडिया से लेखडा पडो पूरा जंगर आईडिया ऑफ लोकनीति राजनीति गांधी से ओशानी कम्युनिटी को डेवलप कर आईडिया ऑफ कम्युनिटी इज देयर मुझे कहली जो इंडिविजुअल कनेक्टेड प्रोफेशनल कम्युनिटी ऑन द वन हैंड एंड टेरिटोरियल कम्युनिटी इन विलेज दे आर इन टर्न कनेक्टेड विथ अपर हायरार्की ऑफ कम्युनिटीज दैट्स हाउ ग्लोबल कम्युनिटी इज फॉर्म्ड दैट इज वन सेकंड गांधी ओशानी कम्युनिटी पर पड़ो जहाँ लिखा है जो गांधी ओरिजिनल राइटिंग्स यू मस्ट ब्रिंग देम टू स्टूडेंट्स मस्ट नो ऑल दैट Oceanic community is partly outlined by
Oceanic community
Gandhinagar sira padho tapare jp develop korchi sira padho that is one classical ground second ground is dayakrishna jeda marmur dayaram is shaila mayaram read an article on intercultural societies she has published a book now read that book or read her article in Rajiv Bhargava's volume she offers a critique of Rajiv Bhargava's multicultural theory read her students can prescribe that
sir article now is intercultural
Shaila Mayaram to Rajiv Bhargava bohira achi to dekhiwo Shaila Mayaram
thik achi ha Mayaram ha Thank you, sir. Vignesh, over to you.
Sir, last questions. Hello, sir.
To whom?
Sir, upon the last question.
Not to me, it's to him only. Okay.
Sir, a question from Aparna Vishwal. What is cultural nationalism?
So, when Patnaik's what is cultural nationalism?
Yes, sir.
So I think I want Patnaik sir to answer because he has defeated me actually. So a defeated fellow right now surrender before Patnaik sir, and I want Patnaik sir to respond.
Okay, see, cultural nationalism. Can be seen in many forms. One is the idea of nationalism in European context, as many liberals argue, essentially territorial nationalism. Territory of a nation is the basis for identifying nation. The French territory, the people speak French language in this territory, so that nation belongs to French speaking population. Similarly, English people, English language is spoken in this territory. Therefore, English nation belongs to people belonging to that territory where English is spoken. So, the linguistic nation was essentially a territorial nation because we didn't speak French language across the world. Generally, we didn't speak English language everywhere. Now that we are speaking English, French, everywhere, that is different. But the idea of nationalism evolved with regard to a territory. Now, liberals therefore have a constructed idea that territory is a benchmark of nation building. Look at the definition of state, Gardner and many others. One of the property of state is territory, population, sovereignty. Now these are all territorial concepts. Sovereignty is again exercised within that territory. State, therefore, nation state has all these attributes: a fixed territory, a fixed population, and a fixed form of sovereignty, and so on and so forth. Therefore, these properties. They taken together are considered territorial nationalism. Now, this is a typical liberal understanding of nation state. To this, many people have challenged. Italian thinker Mazzini challenged this. Therefore, idea of cultural nationalism actually originally evolved from Machiavelli. If you see, read Machiavelli carefully, the founding father of nation state says that nation state is not about territory. Nation state is about promoting national culture. Nation state is about promoting a language, for example. is a cultural attribute. That is not you simply take French population, say that territory where French is spoken, that is primary. But what about French language? Is state is national is established to promote French language or to suppress French language? So language is, how can you say language is a territorial concept? People may speak language in a particular territory, but you cannot say language is a territorial concept. Language is a cultural concept. Therefore, language, religion, and various forms of association, life, they are all part of culture. So culture in a broad sense, in a civilization sense, each nation represents history of civilization. French nation represents history of its own civilization. That quite different from the English civilization. The German nation represents their own history of civilization, their own ancestry. They recall that glorious tradition, etc. So therefore, each nation is connected with cultural history, not simply contemporary culture, but cultural history. That is called cultural nationalism. Therefore, the idea of cultural nationalism, which I originally articulated by Savarkar in Indian context, was actually done in this sense. Territorial nationalism is inadequate to understand nationalism. Nationalism is about culture. Nationalism is certainly about culture. In European context also, it is about culture. Only liberal doctrine has misled the idea of nation and constricted nation to a territory, a fixed population, and fixed form of sovereignty. Whereas nation may share sovereignties, very different kinds of sovereignties. Therefore, traditionally, nations have been cosmopolitan, to be very frank. Early forms of nation was cosmopolitan. English nation was to be shared by many other countries. Similarly, French nation was shared by many other countries. They became colonial, but the colonial empire was also cosmopolitan. They preferred to share the French culture in Algeria, in Pondicherry, in Portuguese culture, in Goa. The sharing of culture is cosmopolitan. The nation building is also rooted in imperial culture, and imperial culture is also cosmopolitan. Tries to filter culture, tries to share culture. The process of this nation states become enriched. Therefore, cultural nationalism is not merely a connotation hinged on religious norms, which what Savarkar did, but cultural nationalism, freed from a religious boundary, will respect religion. Religious communities will contribute to nation building, and many other linguistic communities will contribute to nation building. The nation is established to promote language, religion, food habits, and varieties of dress codes, and so on and so forth. And how do we sport beard, and should there be law respecting the Sikh kripan and Sikh beard? This has been practiced by Indian society for long. Now, Canada established a multicultural act to promote Sikh army. But Indian society has been that Sikh army for a long time. I mean, Indian society has nurtured cultural nationalism of different kind for a long, long period. And most of the liberal and leftists in India don't understand cultural nationalism. They think cultural nationalism is Hindutva, is fascist, is a fraud. That's not true. Cultural nationalism is broadly democratic in character. It can be undemocratic on the hands of evil, but it can be equally democratic. It has been democratic. Look at European history. It has been not focused on territorial nationalism. So cultural nationalism can be democratic. Cultural nationalism can be undemocratic. Cultural nationalism can be fundamentalist. Cultural nationalism can be secular. So don't give up idea of cultural nationalism just because somebody else has misused it. Thank you.
And that is what I am saying, sir, that these people, they understand cultural nationalism and Hindu nationalism, and is a fundamentalist nationalism. So this is a very sectarian or narrow understanding of cultural nationalism.
Yeah, true, I agree.
Yes. Okay, Bigness.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Arun, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
You explain elaborately what is cultural nationalism. Thank you, sir. थैंक यू धन्यवाद देवी समस्त विद्यार्थी गण को जो माने आज क्लास को एते मनोभाव शुणिले स्पेशल थैंक्स देवी प्रोफेसर सोनमयी त्रिपाठी मैडम को प्रोफेसर अरुण पटनायक सर को डॉक्टर हिमांशु शेखर मिश्रा सर को डॉक्टर अंतरियम बेरिया सर को एवं मो कलीग डॉक्टर विजय बेहरा सर को थैंक यू सर
थैंक यू
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Close the session.
Bigness at a bond karo.
Yes, sir. We close the sessions.
हमको रही पापा ही पड़ी वो
यस सर
चार अभी बॉन्ड करी जाई पड़ी भी कुछ असुविधा नहीं सर
निशान निशान
सुमिता मैडम कौन तो
हाँ सर डिस्कनेक्ट कर के अपन जाइए बारी में
यस मैम थैंक यू मैम
मोस्ट वेलकम निशान Can you hear me? Nishan? निशान
हेलो
हाँ निशान रिकॉर्डिंग स्टॉप करो
हाँ
कर दे चलो
हाँ तुम्हें वन हाँ तुम्हें भी बंद कर दियो
ओके
खाता